Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
You're watching South Asia Newsline, and for the top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 19th of June. PM Modi unveils new Nalanda campus, says it will start golden age of India. US lawmakers meet Dalai Lama, warn China on choice of successor. And Sri Lanka's top coach rejects gender equality bill, president criticizes ruling. And now for all the details. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Wednesday inaugurated the new campus of the Nalanda University, an educational institute conceived as a collaboration between India and East Asia summit countries in India's Bihar. Addressing the gathering on the occasion, PM Modi expressed delight in visiting Nalanda within 10 days of taking oath as the Prime Minister and said that it's a positive indication towards the developmental journey of India. He said Nalanda is a proclamation of the truth that knowledge cannot be destroyed even though books would burn in a fire, and added that the revival of Nalanda near its ancient ruins will introduce India's capabilities to the world, as it will tell the world that nation with strong human values are capable of creating a better world by regenerating history.
From all corners into a beacon.
Nalanda, ye kewal naam nahi hai. नालंदा एक पहचान है, एक सम्मान है, नालंदा एक मूल्य है, नालंदा एक मंत्र है, गौरव है, गाथा है, नालंदा है उद्घोष इस सत्य का कि आग की लपटों में पुस्तकें भले जल जाएं, लेकिन आग की लपटें ज्ञान को नहीं मिटा सकती।
Earlier in the day, the Indian Prime Minister also took a tour of the ruins of the ancient Nalanda Mahaviharam, the ancient site of the original university established around 1600 years ago. It's considered to be amongst the first residential universities in the world. It was PM Modi's first visit to the eastern Indian state following the assumption of the charge for the third term. Moving on. At least 5 people were killed this week due to extreme heat in New Delhi, as the northern parts of India continue to remain under a severe heat wave. While the Indian capital experienced the warmest night in 12 years on Wednesday, its power consumption also touched an all-time high on Tuesday. Since March, temperatures have soared to 50 degrees Celsius in Delhi and the nearby state of Rajasthan, while more than twice the usual number of heat wave days were recorded this season in northwest and eastern parts of the country. The weather office has said the conditions are likely to continue and will gradually abate thereafter due to an approaching western disturbance.
हमने पूरा नॉर्थ इंडिया में आज रेड अलर्ट दे चुके हैं, मगर हमारा ये जो रेड अलर्ट का जो वार्निंग है, कल से हम थोड़ा घटाएंगे. मेनली एक पश्चिम विक्षोभ आ रहा है वेस्ट की तरफ, जिसके चलते हमारा जो नॉर्थ वेस्ट, वेस्टर्न हिमालयन रीजन, पंजाब, हरियाणा, इन सभी राज्यों में थोड़ा अरेबियन सी से मॉइस्चर आ रही है, जिसके चलते आज शाम से ही थोड़ा बादल और थोड़ा बारिश का भी उम्मीद है नॉर्थ वेस्ट इंडिया में.
एंड A group of US lawmakers, after meeting the exiled Tibetan spiritual leader, the Dalai Lama in India on Wednesday, said that they would not allow China to influence the choice of his successor. Comments expected to anger Beijing, which calls him a separatist. The team of 7 lawmakers included Democratic former House Speaker Nancy Pelosi. They signaled that Washington would pressure Beijing to hold talks with Tibetan leaders, stalled since 2010, to resolve the Tibet issue, with a bill President Joe Biden is expected to sign soon.
For the Dalai Lama knows that this is not true, that Tibet is part of China. And the people of Tibet know that that is not true. And the United States of America knows that that is not true.
The Dalai Lama fled to India in 1959 after a failed uprising against Chinese rule in Tibet. The 88-year-old is set to fly to the US this week for medical treatment. The question of his successor has been a widely debated issue. China had earlier warned the US lawmakers not to make contact with him and Biden not to sign the bill.
China can express unhappiness if it wants. We're going to stand for what's right. What's right is to make sure that Tibetans have freedom. They are able to return to their native land. They're able to have and live and keep their culture and their history. That's what's right and that's what's important.
And while the Pakistan government has decided to reduce tax exemptions in its annual budget, people are worried that their financial burden is likely to rise further amid soaring inflation. Our report.
Pakistan's Finance Minister Mohammad Aurangzeb on Tuesday reaffirmed the government's commitment to expand the tax net to include more sectors while reducing tax exemptions. His comments followed the recent budget presentation in line with IMF demands, as it sets a challenging ₹13 trillion tax collection target. The new budget has, however, left Pakistanis in major cities upset amid soaring inflation, as the hike in taxes are set to raise their financial burden.
लेकिन कोई देखने वाला नहीं, कोई परेशाने हाल नहीं है, खा रहे हैं ऊपर बैठे हुए, बोल दूं एजेंसी के लोग खा रहे हैं, एस्टेब्लिशमेंट को मिल रहा खाने को, ये अपनी मर्जी करेंगे, कोई चेक एंड बैलेंस नहीं है। जब तक इस मुल्क में चेक एंड बैलेंस नहीं होगा, कुछ भी ठीक नहीं होगा।
पाकिस्तान इज इन टॉक्स विद द IMF फॉर अ लोन ऑफ $6 to $8 billion एज इट सीक्स टू अवर्ट अ डिफॉल्ट फॉर एन इकोनॉमी ग्रोइंग एट द स्लोएस्ट पेस इन द रीजन. The rise in the tax target is made up of a 48% increase in direct taxes and 35% hike in indirect taxes. Non-tax revenue, including petroleum levies, is seen increasing by a whopping 64%.
Moving on, UN expert Richard Bennett has warned that the Taliban's pattern of systematic violations of women's fundamental rights has intensified, causing immense harm spanning generations and all elements of society in Afghanistan. Bennett said that violations are so severe and extensive that they may amount to crimes against humanity. He called on the Taliban to take immediate steps to reverse their system of gender oppression. After seizing power in 2021, Taliban swiftly began curtailing women's rights, including imposing stricter dress codes, banning higher education for girls, excluding women from employment, and restricting freedom of movement in public spaces. And heavy rains in Bangladesh on Wednesday caused heavy flooding in the Sylhet division, leaving large fields and villages inundated and causing rivers in the region swell above the danger level. The incessant rainfall had stopped briefly on Eid, but rain resumed from Tuesday, causing significant overflows in all water bodies. People were seen wading through knee-deep water as over 370,000 people were reportedly stranded in the rural areas. The district administration reported that more than 3,900 people had taken shelter in various flood centers. The Sri Lankan Supreme Court on Tuesday ruled that the enactment of the Gender Equality Bill is inconsistent with Article 12 of the Constitution, prompting President Ranil Wickremesinghe on Tuesday to propose to appoint a select committee to look into the judgment. The Gender Equality Bill seeks to legalize equal opportunities to all, irrespective of sex or gender identity, in Sri Lanka, a Buddhist majority country of 22 million people. The president said the top court has ignored a certain section which the Gender Equality Bill has addressed and has eaten up all the judgments, including one which had been given by a bench of 10 judges with regard to women's rights. The petitioners against the bill had argued that a clause of the bill, if passed, would permit same-sex marriages, hurting the cultural sensitivities of different communities. Homosexual sex is a criminal offence in Sri Lanka, where the penal code dates from British colonial rule. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.